Hello, this is Eddie Mendoza and welcome to Pathways of Hope. In today's Gospel, which is from Luke chapter 6, verse 6 to 11, we see Jesus teaching on a Sabbath in the synagogue. As usual, there are Pharisees and teachers of the law inside that synagogue overseeing everything that's going on in that synagogue. Now, in the middle of his teaching, Jesus is getting ready to heal a man with a crippled hand. But before Jesus does this, he stops and looks at the Pharisees who are waiting for an opportunity and a chance to accuse him of breaking the rules and regulations according to the laws of Moses. Jesus, of course, knows that the Mosaic law forbids all forms of work on a Sabbath. And he remembers the several occasions in the past when the Pharisees would condemn him for healing during the Sabbath. So what does Jesus do? Jesus flips around and challenges them with a question. He asks them, he says, in verse 6, he says, I ask you, which is lawful on the Sabbath? To do good or to do evil? To save life or to destroy it? That's from verse 6. So which is lawful on the Sabbath? To do good or to do evil? Basically, he's asking them not about the healing per se, but about whether there is a law against doing good. The point that Jesus is making is that there is no law, or there should be no law against doing good, especially when it involves caring for people and for showing them mercy. And this is also what I hope to briefly discuss with you today. Namely, to allow ourselves to reflect on where our minds and our hearts are when it comes to extending kindness to others at the spur of the moment. You know, or in other words, when you're in the middle of doing other things. Okay. In today's episode in the synagogue, we see that Jesus is busy teaching. And then, even though it's not in his agenda, and maybe he's still in the middle of his lesson plan, an opportunity to extend kindness and care to someone presents itself. Actually, if you examine the story, the man with the crippled hand didn't disturb the session. He didn't walk to the front and interrupt Jesus in the middle of his homily and his teaching, and he did not go there and beg Jesus to heal him. No, it was Jesus himself who saw the man. Not only is Jesus considering whether to interrupt his teaching, okay, at that very moment, he actually knows and is thinking and is aware of the risk of being yet again hauled to court by the Pharisees, because he remembers how meticulous they are about the laws of doing work on a Sabbath. But what does Jesus do? He immediately takes action, and he does not want that man to wait a single minute longer and continue to suffer. Now, what about you, my dear brothers and sisters? What about us? What would you have done? Now, listen. I do not question your kindness, my dear brothers and sisters. I know that the Lord is in you and the Spirit moves you to extend kindness. Okay? But what I'd like us to examine in ourselves is how we react when faced with unexpected interruptions, which are opportunities actually to do good to someone, when it's not necessarily in our best interest at that very moment to take action and to extend kindness right there and then. Let's say you're driving in traffic in the rain and you're rushing to go to an important prayer meeting. What's your reaction to motorcycles or to bicyclists who block your path and slow you down and make you arrive late to that meeting? Okay. What are your biases about beggars on the street who just suddenly appear by the window of your car asking for alms? Do you extend kindness? Do you have a bias against beggars because you think they're part of a syndicate? I mean, where did that come from? Or are you concerned about breaking the law and slowing down traffic behind you while you grab a few coins from your purse and then you have to give it to the beggar. The other day, my wife and I were eating dinner at a fancy restaurant inside a brand new mall. You know how it is where there are tables outside the entrance of the mall, outside the entrance of the restaurant. You know, it's like an overflow place, you know, and there are people walking by because it's part of the lobby. Yes, well, that's where our table was. And in the middle of our meal, a young girl dressed properly, if I may say, you know, a young girl approached our table and begged us for alms so that she could have something to eat. My first impulse was I was tempted to say, "Hey, what are you doing here? You're not allowed to beg inside the mall. It's against the rules." But instead, I quickly pulled out my wallet and gave her something, hoping that no one would catch her and stop her from seeking help from others inside the mall. Do you remember the parable of the Good Samaritan? If you had somewhere important to go, but you saw that there was a need to extend kindness to a stranger, where would your mind and your heart be at that precise moment? I think the lesson in today's gospel is clear. Let me just point out three short lessons and quickly. First, again, let me say, there is no law against kindness. And neither should we place stumbling blocks or even excuses to withhold kindness when it's within our power to be of help. Number two, in fact, the law of God requires and demands kindness, you know, even when it means dying to ourselves, sacrificing our own time, talent, and treasure in order to extend love to our neighbors. And third, finally, and perhaps the most encouraging of all, I want you to remember, my dear brothers and sisters, the Sacred Heart of Jesus suffers whenever he sees people suffering. Jesus will not wait before he takes action to extend kindness and grace. Jesus will always prioritize doing what is best for you and for me. So there, my brothers and sisters, yes, we are commanded to extend love to our neighbors. And today, we are reminded today that the reason that you and I can love others, the main reason that you and I can love others, the reason why we can love others is because God loved us first. Again, this is Eddie Mendoza and God bless us all.